Hello everyone, today we're going to talk about the Nashorn. We've talked about this armored fighting vehicle in the past, but that was barely 3 minutes long, so I decided to give it a new video. Let's try to hit the 120 likes within 24 hours. Anyway, without further ado, let's get right into the video. The Nashorn was built on the chassis of the PanzerKampfwagen III and IV. This chassis got a 88mm Puck 43/1 L71 gun mounted on it, the strongest anti-tank gun Germany had available at the time. This main armament was widely used in the German military. This was for example also fitted on other armored fighting vehicles like the JagdPanther and the Ferdinand, which was also known as the Elephant. They used the 88mm PZgr.39 as their main armour piercing round. The shell would have a shell velocity of 1000 meters per second and could penetrate up to 182 mm of 30 degree sloped armour steel at a distance of 500 meters away. This is also part of the reason why some people call it the AFV, which can take out all tanks but also can be taken out by all tanks. On the other hand, their high explosive shell was the 88mm Sprgr. This was mainly to deal with soft targets. They also had a tungsten cored shell, which was the PZgr.40. However, this shell is rarely used since Germany generally lacked the materials to create these kinds of shells. However, this shell is more effective at shorter distances in terms of armor penetration because it could penetrate up to 226 mm of steel at 500 meters. This would mean that in theory the Nashorn could knock out the mouse from its sides at a distance of 500 meters. These shells were stored in two bins on each side of the tank. These bins could contain 16 shells combined and an additional 24 shells could be stored on the floor. Due to the low shell storage, more shells were generally supplied by Maultier half-tracks, and the secondary armaments included either MG34s or MG42s. The Nashorn had a Maybach HL120 engine which could produce up to 300 horsepower. Its top speed was 40 km an hour and off-road that would be reduced to 25 km an hour. The Nashorn also had an operational range of 213 km, which would be reduced to 130 if they weren't on the road. Like I stated before, this is an armored fighting vehicle which could be knocked out by every vehicle but could also knock out every vehicle. This is allowed by the fact that they almost had no armor. Its thickest point is only 30mm thick and it had an open roof. This also lets you be vulnerable to flamethrowers, grenades and any form of shrapnel. Its best protection would be a well-concealed place where you could quickly retreat out of. Moving after you fired your first shell makes you considerably more difficult to be spotted, or only exposing your main armament for example. This makes you more difficult to be hit as well. This was a luxury the duck-in Nashorn had. The Nashorn was 6.2 meters long and just over 2.9 meters wide and tall, and in total this AFV has been produced a mere 494 times. During its production time, the Nashorn was never seriously upgraded. This is because the Nashorn was a temporary solution. The only modifications the Nashorn received were those to make the production less complicated and easier. The Nashorn made its combat debut in the Battle of Kursk alongside other rookies like the Panther and the Ferdinand. So now we're going to get into their service history, but there are a lot of Sprgr Panzerjäger Abteilung slash companies, so from now on I will just refer to them by their number instead of their long name. Of course there are quite a lot of these, so I decided to take the most interesting apart and make the video about them. So let's start with the 88th. In May 1944, a Nashorn from the 88th managed to knock out a IS-2 Soviet heavy tank. They immediately destroyed the IS-2, however they didn't realize that it was actually a captured IS-2 and it was being towed back. In late January, an unknown number of Nashorns from this unit were supporting the German defense of Preiswitz during these actions. Some Nashorn of the 88th were equipped with experimental night vision equipment, but in what numbers and how effective this system was is unknown. The 519th received their latest Nashorn in November 1943 and this counted to be 45 of these Nashorns in total. They were repositioned to support the 3rd Panzer Army, where they first saw their first real action at the Battle of Vitebsk, where the advancing Soviet forces were stopped. It would be stationed there from 1943 December until 1944 January, and during this time they would repel a lot of Soviet attacks. Between the 10th of December and the 24th of February, the 519th claimed to have destroyed 290 tanks while only losing 6 of their own. 4 of them had been destroyed by their own crew. After this, they saw little action and were assigned to help the 4th in Belorussia. By the end of June, they claimed to have an additional 112 tank kills. By the end of 1944 July, it lost many of their Nashorns, and what was left was used to support the PanzerKampfwagen Gruppe Hoppe. By August 1944, like other units, the 519th was also sent to Milau to be equipped with JagdPanthers and also to be equipped with Stuk 3s. The most notable Nashorn ace was a platoon commander of the 1st Company of the 519th, Junior Lieutenant Albert Ernst. On December 23, 1943, he destroyed 14 Soviet tanks in a single day using only 21 rounds of ammunition. The engagement took place near Vitebsk, and Albert Ernst was given the nickname Tiger of Vitebsk. In December 1943, Ernst destroyed a total of 19 enemy tanks, and January 22nd of 1944 he was awarded the Knight's Cross. The 655th. In April 1943, this unit had 35 vehicles. The last 10 vehicles arrived in May. The unit assembly and training was carried out until June 1943, and by the time of the Kursk offensive, the 655th was part of the Heeresgruppe Mitte, but was not directly involved in combat. It would, however, be engaged with the 2nd Army in trying to stop the Soviet attacks. This defense proved to be unsuccessful, and the unit was forced to pull out in the direction of the Desna and Dniepr rivers. In a report dated 1st of July, the 655th was noted to have lost 8 vehicles. 1 to a mine and the remaining 7 during an air raid. From November till the end of 1943, the 655th was mostly used in support of a different panzer division, both in attack and defense. My opinion. In my opinion, this is a great anti-tank vehicle. This should be used as a tote anti-tank piece. Its only difference is that it's self-propelled. However, this was often misused by local commanders. Its 88mm was incredibly strong, which could take out all the tanks which were fielded at the time. A drawback was in fact that it was quite large and it was more difficult to conceal in a short time, and its slow traverse speed didn't help either. But the tank was relatively cheap to produce, which was a positive, and another downside was that it had an open top. However, even with these downsides, the Nashorn proved to be effective. This can be seen in a report of Company 521 during the operation of defending Oriel in mid-July 1943, when the following vehicles were claimed to have been destroyed: 1 KV-2, 19 KV-1 SS, 430 T-34s, 1 M3 Lee, 1 T-60 and 5 T-17s, and 1 rocket launcher mounted on a tank chassis. However, these numbers are just claims and probably were larger than reality. But from this data I've just read through, it seems like it's a highly formidable tank if the local commanders didn't misuse it. Anyway guys, that was the video. I opened a brand new Discord server, the link will be in the comments below. When you join, within 7 days of this video's release, you will get a pre-2k rank, which will show you follow my channel before the 2000 subscribers, and you will keep this rank forever. I will also leave my Instagram in the comments, and if you want to support my channel by making a small donation, you can go to my channel's homepage. And other than that, have a very, very good day.